the lamp?
Oh, I moved it up against the wall.
Why?
To save money like Dad wanted. See, now it's closer to the outlet, so the electricity doesn't have to travel so far. It was my idea.
How am I supposed to read the newspaper?
I'm way ahead of you, Grandma. See, I canceled your newspaper. It will save money on that, too.
How the hell am I supposed to know what's going on in the world?
Just ask me.
Oh, my God.
Get away from me. Get away from me.
Terry, admit it. You were taking a shower when you weren't supposed to.
I admit nothing.
Terry, the towel and the soap are wet.
I was washing my hands.
No, you weren't. I have proof that you were in the shower.
Oh, yeah? What proof?
I'm just a lie machine. I'm nobody but you. Ooh, yeah. I'm just a lie machine.
Get a life, baby.
Mom, Terry took an unauthorized shower. Do something.
Hey, where's my desk lamp?
Oh, it's upstairs against the wall in your bathroom. This crusade to save money has gotten completely out of hand.
Hair, hair. Now, wait a minute. Ron asked us to cut back, and I think we should listen to him. He deserves our complete respect.
So what do you think?
I think it's an improvement.
Yeah, the cavity's open.
I'll get it.
Ron, bad idea. Just go in.
Hello, Norbert. What a surprise.
Hello, Ellen. I hope you don't mind my stopping by like this.
No, not at all. Come on in. What brings you by?
Oh, nothing in particular. A little of this, a little of that. Miscellaneous school business.
Oh, I see. What?
Let's see. A case of Play-Doh arrived today. Extra blue, per your request. What else? The volleyball pump is back in pumping order. Yippee! I'd like you to cancel your next field trip. Okay, I'll see you in the AM.
Norbert, why do you want me to cancel my field trip?
Oh, well, we have a policy of not allowing teachers to bring students into their homes.
Since when?
Oh, since, about, 2 hours ago. Of course, I've never had to enforce it till now.
Wait a minute, what's going on? Did somebody object to this field trip?
Well, not someone, Ellen. Mrs. Kelly, I'm not donating $250,000 to the new library unless this field trip is canceled, Fairchild.
I never knew her middle name before. This is all because Ron is black, isn't it?
Black? Well, I never noticed, but... apparently, she did.
Oh, I can't believe this. I never figured her for a racist.
Boop, boop, boop. Ellen, and a flag on the play. This woman is not a racist.
Oh, come on.
No, she simply feels that 5-year-olds are too young to understand the concept of an interracial family. And since bringing the kids to your home is not standard school curriculum, well, she feels she's justified in making this request. Frankly, I agree.
Well, why doesn't she just keep Jessica home that day?
No go. For her, this is a matter of principle. She feels it's not proper for you to mix your private life with your professional responsibilities.
But I'm not doing that. This isn't a field trip to an interracial family. It's a trip to a dentist who happens to be my husband, who happens to be black.
Look, Ellen, I know that you feel your family is perfectly normal. But for other people, this arrangement is very unusual.
There is nothing unusual about this family.
Well, you know, Lester, I think that the big salaries are what's ruining the sport. Hey, Norbert, how you doing?
Hey, what about artificial turf?
Oh, please, don't get me started on that.
Okay, you know, a little unusual.
Look, Ellen, let's just take a look at the situation. On the one hand, you have a little
boring, nothing field trip. And on the other hand, you've got a great, big, new, fabulous library. They're not equal, are they?
Norbert, if I don't cancel this field trip, am I going to be fired?
Let's not even think about that, Ellen.
Look, for right now, I just want you to relax. Get a good night's sleep. Think this thing through. Look into your heart. Come in tomorrow and cancel the field trip.
Good night.